Hi, this is Pam. Welcome back to my channel. If you're new, welcome. I have not done a video in about 2 weeks. 1 week I was rearranging my craft room, so I'll do a tour of that next week. Then I've been making these little journals here out of vintage quilt. So I'll show you, I'll just do a little quick little flip through of these. They're not embellished totally or you know, so I'm just gonna show you what I've been working on. So I have these four and they'll be listed probably Monday, I hope. So let's just look at one. and they're a vintage quilt, and you know, they weren't sewn perfectly, and that's okay. These are little wonkies. And then I'm going to be putting little things on them, little snippets and buttons and things. But I had this fun fringe. And then they all have this colorful pom-poms. It's got one signature. Some might have rickrack. And then in the inside, they all have this vintage Chanel bedspread, which is a big pocket. Some little rosettes here. And then there's a lace pocket here. And then you have a pocket here and stenciling. I'm just going to go real quick because it's not finished. But this is just what I've been working on. Then I have a couple other things I'll share with you. Excuse me. So like I said, these should be listed probably Monday, but I'll do a flip through first once it's finished. So just wanted to let you know what I've been doing. Took me a long time to rearrange things, and so I was ongoing, but I do like to organize. So yeah, that's just a fun little quilted journals. They're about 6.5 by 6.5 with 6 by 6 pages. And there's another one of these pockets, so that's what I've been working on for those. And then I thought I would also share, excuse me, I finally broke down and bought a Somerset studio. This, I think there's all different types, but this is an interactive mixed media journal issue. They're like $15, which is kind of expensive. I mean, magazines are expensive, but this is volume 23, issue 3, and it was August, September, October, 2019. So I thought I'd show you, in case you might want to buy one, what is in the issue. So they have, excuse me, different kinds. Artful Blogging, Art Doll, Altered Couture, Artist Cafe, Green Craft. That would be interesting. Handbags, Jewelry Affair, Prims, Primitives, Sew, Somerset Apprentice, and that's mixed media for the beginner. Digital Studio, Home, Somerset Life, Take 10, Stampers, Sampler. So it'd be nice to have all those, huh? And then there's one, too, in her studio about different craft rooms. Just more art type journals, which I haven't really done a lot of. Just mainly, how pretty these are. I've just done mainly journals. Many albums in the past, so that's pretty. And then they have these papers, These are their really thick artist papers, Stampington and Company. An index card a day by Christian Van Valkenburg. I had never heard of that. As they call it, ICAD challenge, index card a day. That's what it stands for, ICAD. Look at these beautiful altered index cards. Pretty. And then here they have in these books, you know, things to do, create a collage, get messy with your napkins. Look at, they even altered a scotch tape roll. And they have different techniques and how they do them. Very beautiful. Look at this. Here's some more papers. That's really pretty. Another artist paper. These are pretty. From napkins. Gorgeous. I love these colors. The red and the aqua or teal and the cream. Those are very pretty. I think for Christmas I'm going to get a subscription to one of these magazines. Isn't that pretty? And then more things that you could practice doing. An altar type box and book cover. More like mixed media. Frayed and folded fabric folders. This is beautiful. Pretty. Altered postcards. Inspiration cards. Beautiful colors. Pretty. So anyway, well, here's some more entries that people have sent in. Here's some more art paper. I don't want to bore you if you're not interested in this, but yeah, that's what this magazine has. Somerset Studio, and this is the Interactive Mixed Media Journal. So I thought I'd share that in case you're interested in that, wanted to know what it was like. Also, I'm going to be doing a little giveaway. I'm going to be giving away these dies that I received from In Love Art Shop. They sent them to me to review. So I've cut out quite a few, so now I'd like to give them away. This is really pretty heart tag die. There's, oh, looks like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, maybe 6 dies in there. So if you're interested, just say, enter me or just comment. That one, this is kind of a doily type die. Pretty. Cuts well. And this is what I used to make this little journal. And I put rings through here and added some little fibers and fabrics and ribbon. And then this was my punch die. And then I added, this is from the other smaller die here. Oops, a little glare. So you have that little tag with some twine. And you open it up, and then I emboss that with a heart emboss folder, some little fibers. There's a cute tag here. And then here you have a cute, another one of these embossed. And you could write here, random picture. Here's another spot that you could add something to, picture or whatever. This is from my heart punch, one of my heart punches, and I added a little word there, embrace. More for writing. This is from that other heart die. More writing spaces. And then you have another little heart here with these pretty little fibers and twine. And you could write in here, or you could add a picture, writing, another little heart die tag that's been embossed. It's fun and easy to make. Excuse me. You could even, you know, have your, you know, kids help you with this one, or let them make their own little creation, or these are cute for little gifts. Writing, different embossing heart, then you just get your ring binders and you're all set. And I made a little shaker, this is thicker, I cut it out some thicker. That little shaker. Then here, a little heart made out of craft paper. All the little hearts. This is sweet. Tag fits in there. Then that is the back. So this will be the giveaway. You'll be getting this set of dies, this die, and this doily die. So just let me know if you are interested, and not just say you want to be entered, or just let me know. Okay, I have that, and then I thought I would show you. I just love embroidery. That's my thing. So over the years, I've collected embroidered pillowcases. And then for a while, I went to two little places where you could sell crafts. And I made little pillowcase dresses. And I have a whole bunch in the basement. Now this one in my little shop is called Button Littles, and I even bought the little sizes and things. And this one I have to redo because it has some staining on it. But I love the embroidery on these. They're just so beautiful, and the edging, the crochet. And a pillowcase dress, you take a pillow and then you you know, you're going to cut your armholes and sew that under, and then you put your ribbon through the top, you know, that's been sewn, and then you tie them. So I don't know what I'm going to do. If I'm going to try to sell them again, of course the season's over now, but I'll decide by next year. But I have quite a few of these, so I'll show you my other ones later. But I just found some, and I'll show, you know, some that I have now. But so I have to work on this one though, because there's some, I didn't realize there's a little bit of staining there. And this one has these cute little deers. Isn't that pretty? I wish my lighting was better. I don't have any overhead lighting. And then this really pretty pink crochet. So see, you would, you know, make your sew under and then sew this under, and then you'd gather your ribbon through here. You have a tiny little dress. And I haven't looked at these, I just pulled them out, so I don't really know why I didn't do these. And these are, this must just be because I hadn't finished these. So same thing. Look at the beautiful work on here. Let's see if I can. There. Isn't that pretty? I don't know. So what do? I have to decide whether I'm going to try to make dresses from them or cut them up and journal, because now I'm not really into sewing so much. Now my low is journals, so I have two of those. What else do I have? Here's a peacock. And what I did was, when I got these, I had a formula. I haven't done it in quite a few years, but you know, where you soak and re-soak and get the yellowing out and put it in the sun. Excuse me. Pretty edging on here. And there's a peacock with these pretty little flowers. So maybe next week I'll show you my pillowcase dresses that I have made. But I just found these and I thought, oh, let me share these because my journals aren't completed. So I can't quite show those yet. And I haven't had a video in 2 weeks, so I thought I would share them. This. Yep, we got two of these. Look at that. I just love that. It's my favorite thing to find. Oh, I bought these all like on eBay. I rarely find these at a thrift shop. I have to purchase these. And they're not cheap. So, you know, that's why it's hard. I think I might frame some and put them in my craft room or in a bedroom or something, but I just really appreciate all this work here. It's just really beautiful. So I have two of those. And then I have, and I just pulled these out. I have a lot more of these. I don't even remember these. This is beautiful. Two of these. Oh my gosh. So pretty. What do you do? This is just too gorgeous. I think I'll use some of these on beds, you know, with pillowcases here. Look at this. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Seriously. Is there anything prettier than this? Look at that. I don't know, this may be even a more of a modern piece, but I don't care. It still looks, I mean, they did it in a vintage style and it's beautiful. I have two of those. I have, what else I got? A couple more to show you. Two of these. Embroidered lady with a little butterfly. Let's open it up. It's just fun to look at them. You know how some people just like to collect craft supplies and just look at them? There's nothing wrong with that. And I just like to look at this embroidery. Two of those. And then this last one. Set. Just love the feel of this. Such a soft cotton. Two of these with a pretty, it's like a thicker embroidery on the edge. one of those colors. So look at all those little knots in the work. Love them. So that's what I have. I just had found that. I know I have lots more, so I'll show those someday. Another thing, I bought a Scan-A-Cut for myself for Mother's Day. I buy all my own gifts. And I have to look up what DigiKit. I have lots of DigiKits, and I need to find a better system to know what's what. So I'll have to list who this is from. But I thought maybe if I could take my phone out, I could show you a basic scan and cut. I'm not an expert at anything kind of mechanical like that. So I'll just show you what I do. And, you know, if you have a lot of other questions, you might have to ask somebody else. I don't scan and save. All I wanted my scan and cut for was to cut out digitals. And I think you can also cut, you know, stamped images.